is a translational research program that helps academicians take early discoveries in biomedicine and mature them to a project that can impact patients and society. In 2011, a professor at Stanford have invited Collen Masimirembwa to come and give a talk at Stanford. In that talk, he highlighted the fact that drug that is used to treat patients with HIV/AIDS, or component of a drug called efavirenz, is metabolized in sub-Saharan African very differently from Caucasian.
Over 30 to 40% of the people in Zimbabwe have very bad reactions to this drug, whereas in Europe only 5%. So we have come up with a genetics tool which helps us to identify those 40% who are likely to have very serious adverse drug reactions. And those would be given a drug dose which is individualized or personalized to their genetic makeup.
I went to the World Health Summit in Berlin, where I talked to one of the people in charge of distributing the drug in sub-Saharan Africa. And what he told me is this drug, that the reason why HIV/AIDS is still common in sub-Saharan Africa and in Zimbabwe is because patients don't take their medication. And then he said it is a cultural thing. And I think that attitude was rather the trigger for me to become more involved in this project.
First, you don't bring in drugs which don't work on your people. And when they come, you give them at the right dose, which do not create a new disease, sort of adverse drug reactions, which you now also have to treat. And for us to understand how to translate that knowledge and finding into a clinical solution, that was one of the reasons why we sent some of our students for training on how do you translate a lab result into a clinical solution.
I talked more with Collen, and clearly there was a need to identify a test that it will distinguish the metabolism rate from one patient to the other. So the idea that we had was to bring students from Zimbabwe to Stanford to help them develop this assay and automate it so that they can apply it back in sub-Saharan Africa and then develop a clinical trial that could show whether the drug is equally efficacious when dosed appropriate to the genetic traits that determine the metabolism of the drug.
Sending those cohorts of students for training helped us to come up with a solution which we called gene dose, which is now a clinical solution to addressing the side effects to the antiretroviral drugs. So we believe this is a very clear result or outcome from this interaction within the SPARK family.
The story of SPARK Zimbabwe, and specifically the project that Collen Masimirembwa is running in the AiBST, is a perfect exemplification that know-how, smart, experience is not restricted geographically, that there are terrific scientists everywhere in the world, and many of them are making discoveries that can impact patients not only locally, and as in the case of Collen, but also globally.
Instead of me just depending on two experts in genetics in Zimbabwe, I can now access hundreds. Then secondly, we do not have a history or a tradition of translational research. And SPARK is made up of people who have explored this value chain. So Africa can then tap into those diverse experiences of how to transition from discovery, development, and deployment of products. And by being a member of SPARK, we become beneficiaries of the collective skill.